to be here. And I have to say that Brad McDuffie is a superb reader of poetry. I benefited greatly from his perceptive and insightful readings. As he said, I'm just looking at my watch so I don't bore you all terribly. Careful about this. I don't believe in long poetry readings. Sending your audience to a coma is not a good idea. Better a haiku than an epic delivered orally. I will read mostly from this new book and then a few new poems that have been written since the book. So, to begin with, this book, in a way, is a ghost story. The title is Ghost in a Red Hat, and the first poem is about a ghost, and the last poem in the book is about a different ghost. I'm starting with the first ghost. Mediterranean. When she disappeared on the path ahead of me, I leaned against a twisted oak. All I saw was evening light where she had been. Gold dust light, where a moment before, and 38 years before that, my substantial mother strode before me in straw hat, bathing suit, and loose flapping shirt. Every summer afternoon, her knapsack light across her back, her step in sandals firm on the stony path as we returned from the beach. And I mulled small rebellions and observed the dwarfish cork trees with their pocky bark, the wind-rustled oaks with arms akimbo, while shafts of sea light stabbed down between the trunks. There was something I wanted to say at the age of 12, some question she hadn't answered. And yesterday, so clearly seeing her face before me, it rose again to the tip of my tongue. And the mystery was not that she walked there 10 years after her death, but that she vanished and let twilight take her place.